everyone, it's me, Marcy, and today let's have some fun with transparent enamels. It's glass, of course, and it's powder-like, and I like transparent glass enamels because I started out in watercolors before I did this, and it reminds me a little bit of that. We're going to be doing like color wash over existing colors, and what that does is it enhances what we have already, our color vocabulary. We can make new colors, more colors, and what the heck, why not enhance our palettes? So what I'm going to do is flip you around and put you in the holder, and away we go. So before we get started torching, because you know I love to melt glass, I want to show you something first, and that's the bead that I made using this. And can you see that yummy purple in there? And the coral is awfully pretty too. Well, guess what? It still is a coral, but that wasn't that color purple at all. Let me show you what I did and how to make it. I really like Thompson enamels. This is the 9400 series, and this is cherry pink. This is 9480, and I get them in the large container, so you can see the pink color on it, and it's this color that to me makes periwinkle magical, a magical purple. I use this with, normally it's hard to talk for this thing, but normally I would wear a mask and the ventilation on and be extra careful, but I do work out of my jar. I just take off the lid, dunk in, put the lid back on, minimal dust flying that way. And I'm very careful because this is plastic, and if you aren't careful, you're gonna have a problem. So just wanna mention that as well. So let's get started melting. Here we go. I'm using my minor torch, which is the one that I use most of the time. I've had it for, I think I've been melting glass for about 20 years now. Gosh, time flies when you're having fun, doesn't it? Oh, and I wanted to mention some of the colors that I make with this cherry pink. This is cherry pink on white, and this is the purple that I get using it with periwinkle. And let me show you just a couple other variations. This one is with opal yellow. I sure hope that you're able to see this. And what else do we have here? Oh, the others will be harder to see. This one is with a straw yellow. No weather. My sleeve will help you see that a little bit. And it's really pretty as a transparent pink also. This is just with clear at the tray, transparent. Think how expensive pink is normally and how much money you save just using a little bit of this. Okay, so let's make a bead. I'm gonna use a 3/32 mandrel. I'm rolling up my sleeves. I don't think you can see that. My lid is ready to go. I've got my marver nearby. And I'm just grabbing my mandrel. Okay. So let's melt some glass, and I do it towards the end of the mandrel. I'm using Dip and Go Blue Sludge because that's my favorite. And it holds like concrete. I think I keep telling everybody that, but that's just the way I feel about it. And oh, this part's always the longest, melting beads. So you guys can discuss amongst yourself for a minute, or we can tell old stories, or I don't know. Maybe there's something interesting going on in everybody's lives that you really want to tell me about. I'm open to all of that. You can comment, make some comments, that would be fun, or you can ask me questions in the comments. Probably relating to glass would be a good idea because this video will be on YouTube as well later on. I'm just melting a little periwinkle. This periwinkle is nice. It's one of my favorite colors to use. It's a good medium color. It goes with so many of the other colors that we use. And it just never seems to pop or have problems. It's kind of silky smooth. It works well. And you might hear extra noises. It just started raining hard outside. And I hear birds making lots of noises. And who knows what else is going on out there. Okay, let's marver this down a little bit using my Coté marver. And noisy birds. Makes me wonder whether you can hear them. A little marver here. And I'm not looking for a particular bead shape or anything fancy. I want to show you the color more than anything else. And we're just having fun. This is a play bead. And I will take my slotted paddle and even up the ends a little bit more too. This is a slotted paddle. They don't really make this particular one anymore, but they're equivalents to this. And one of them, I think, is called a V-shaper. And I know that Kiss My Glass has been carrying those. And I think Blue Moon Glassworks has some. And I'm not sure where everywhere else is that carries them. Almost there. If we don't worry about it too much, it will just make life a lot easier. I'm going to add a little bit of the coral because these are the three colors that we're going to be using: coral, ephitrae, turquoise, and periwinkle. Let's add some of the coral so you can see what it does with the transparent pink. So we'll add a couple of rings of it. Don't want to make them too large because I really love how the purple looks. So we're going to melt those in. And what we do is I've got this bead has heated up and melted in the coral. We'll give it a quick little marver. Sorry if the camera moves a little bit. I have a very strong magnetic strip right above that both the camera is set to, but also where I keep all my tools. So sometimes when I'm grabbing a tool, if I don't have it down next to me, it kind of wiggles other things. And we'll fix the ends real fast. Give them a little correction, and we're going to be adding more glass later on, just a little bit, so I'm not too worried about that. Okay, so first thing we're going to do is take the lid off, and we have our transparent pink, cherry pink enamel. I'm heating up the bead, not super hot, but warm enough that the enamel will stick to it. Got a nice solid glow on it, and I just place it in, rotate, tap a little bit so that the extra falls back in, and pull it out. Heat it up, and we're going to repeat multiple times. So of course, depending upon how much pink you want to add is how many times you go back and do this. For me, usually about four, sometimes five, depends. You want to be sure to get the very ends also. into the enamels. Good, now we're getting thunder also. And I'm heating up the bead to give it a little bit of a marver because it kind of got a little bit out of whack there. But boy, it did get pretty purple. Bit of the turquoise for decoration. I need to do a little more marbling here. That looks uneven. There we go. And let's make this end slimmer also like that one. So we're just heating it up. And then we'll marble it down so that it's smaller. And your basic fine one, right? Now, sometimes if you put too much heat in one place, you'll lose some of your enamel. So what I can do is just go back before I start adding the surface decoration and add a touch more enamel to it. And because it's transparent, you don't get huge lines from the amount that you add. So I added a little extra there. And then you can let it cool a little bit and add it spot heat and add more in other places just by how much heat you put on it. So more stuff to where it was warmer than in the cooler area. Okay. So we're gently heating. Okay, so we're going to add some dots. I don't normally make dots. Dots are not my thing. Feels funny not doing sculptural stuff. The thing with sculpture and this style of adding the enamels is I like it, but it adds it into crevices a little bit more thickly than if you were just doing a traditionally shaped bead. So you want to be careful how you do that in sculpture, but boy, it can add a lot too. I like it with flowers a little bit, and the reason why is it gets stuck in the petals, so you have some kind of shadows and highlights that way, which I think is really kind of pretty. Let's add one more set of dots. I like doing things on angles. I'm not very much a straight line type person. I'm not sure that you can tell that about me. So I'm going to heat up some of this glass to run through. If you have a favorite pick and you like to do it that way, that's fine. But I tend to use a piece of glass when I'm running it through the dots to form either leaves or hearts or some sort of design. We're going to let that cool a little bit. And we're going to get those dots melted in, and then we'll heat up one line at a time. So if maybe your ends are a little bit too skinny, you can always add a little more glass there, and it could be like bigger dots or change your design around. Do whatever you want to do. Can you see that luscious purple? Yummy. Okay, let's heat up a line of dots, and we're going to drag the glass through it. And we want to heat up enough on either side of it so we can pull it through. And let's see, we're going to start here. I love that little design that it makes. Can you see that? Okay, we're going to heat that back up and even things out because it's got a little bit of a divot through it where I dragged it. It's not so gentle. Okay. So that came up. There isn't a divot in there anymore, and it got the kind of little leafy, hardy, tart, whatever you want to call it, design in it. We're going to do it on the other side now, on the other line of dots. When was the last time you did this? I always like dragging a string of two dots. Okay, well, not hot enough. A little more heat. There we go. Whether we're done. We almost are. I think I can make it look just a little bit better. Oh, are you like me? Do you fuss with your beads? This is why I do sculpture. It's easier to tell when something's done. I'm gonna add just a little end there. Turquoise with the purple and the pinky red, and we're going to add a little line up here also, just to frame it a tiny bit. I'm being very careful because it's so close to the edge. You can see the mandrel there, but boy, it's close. Okay, so that's the bead, and you get to see the pretty purple and the turquoise and the coral. Thanks for joining me, and hope you go and experiment with transparent enamels. This is Marcy Lamberson saying catch you later. Bye.